Hello there. Today we're having a look at the synoptic weather chart. Now this is the first time we've looked at this, so we need to go through exactly what it's about and what it is used for. Right, let's have a look at what a synoptic chart is made up of. First of all, there is a base map, and the base map consists of the outline of land masses, in this case Southern Africa and Madagascar, and it also consists of lines of latitude and lines of longitude. The latitude here is, well, the northern edge of the map is 0 degrees, and then here is 20 degrees south, 40 degrees south, and 60 degrees south. That means that most of the map down here is the mid-latitudes, and then most of South Africa, or all of South Africa, in fact, lies in the subtropics over here. Right, that is superimposed on a map of the pressure systems and storm systems, and again, there's additional layers of information. First layer of information that we have are the pressure systems shown by the isobars. These are all lines joining equal pressure, and the units here, 1016, 1020, and so on, are in hectopascals. The average pressure is about 1013, so anything over 1013, in this case 1020, or over here 1032, is very much a high pressure. Sometimes there are relatively low areas, so here it's marked by a dotted line to show that this is just a weak low pressure embedded in that high pressure. Then the low pressures, here over here is an intense low, 992 hectopascals. These are pretty low pressures. And then in addition to the pressure information, there is weather system information. So here we have cold and warm fronts. There's a cold front, another cold front there, and the cold fronts are marked by little triangular symbols. And the warm fronts, you can see it over here, marked by little round symbols on that line. You will see better examples of that in the next slide. Right, so let's have a look at a typical winter synoptic chart. We're going to look at a number of features. We're looking for anticyclones. Anticyclone is just another name for high pressure, and we can call them highs or anticyclones completely interchangeably. Mid-latitude cyclones are cyclones with fronts, and a cyclone is a low pressure. Not all low pressures are cyclones, but all cyclones are low pressures. Then the isobars also tell us areas of strong wind, areas of calm, as well as little local winds, such as the berg wind. Right, so we start off, and there is the South Atlantic anticyclone on account of it is a high pressure in the South Atlantic Ocean, and it has a name because this is a fairly stable feature. It is somewhere in this vicinity all the time. Likewise, over here, there is the South Indian Ocean, and of course, if there is a high pressure in the South Indian Ocean, we're going to call it the South Indian Anticyclone. Now, the form and position of these anticyclones is very important. So if we have a look at the South Atlantic anticyclone, we see in fact that here's another high pressure, is really part of this. It's all part of the same high pressure system. And what we say is that the South Atlantic anticyclone is extending or ridging in like that south of the country, and that causes an onshore airflow. Now, I'm not expecting you to understand this at this stage, but I'm just illustrating how we can interpret the pressure systems. And that onshore airflow is going to cause, over here, along the Mpumalanga escarpment, probably cause some mist. And that process is called ridging. In this area here, we have a cold front. Another one here. And another one over there. Now, what's interesting about this one is that the person who drew this noticed the weather symbols here are hand-drawn, person who drew this has neglected to put the little triangles on that. So I suspect this must have been a Monday morning or something. And then those are cold fronts. And I mentioned in the previous slide that we have warm fronts marked by not triangles, but little round symbols. So there is a warm front, and there is another one there, and another one over here. Okay, the pressure isobars also tell us the wind direction. I mentioned that it blows anti-clockwise around the high pressure. So there is anti-clockwise around the South Atlantic anticyclone, and this little diagram here tells us that the wind direction is into that circle. So the wind is blowing anti-clockwise, and the South Indian Ocean likewise, the South Indian Ocean anticyclone, there it is blowing anti-clockwise. Around the low pressures, the wind is going to blow clockwise. And likewise there, clockwise. Now that means, of course, that you can see that between those two systems, all the wind directions are going to be, in this case, from west to east. This area here, the isobars are very close together, and that means there is a very high wind speed. If we go into this area, the isobars are far apart, that is going to be pretty calm. Right, so the isobars tell us wind direction and wind strength. They are showing a wind blowing around the high pressure and offshore. Now that is a very hot wind, and it is called the berg wind. So once again, let us just remind ourselves, over here is the South Atlantic anticyclone, over here is the South Atlantic anticyclone. Over here is the South Indian anticyclone. But what makes this very typical of a summer situation is the fact that there is a trough of low pressure across the interior. Remember, in winter there was that high pressure, the interior high. Typically in summer there would be a low pressure extending down from the equatorial regions like that. And then in late summer we may well have a tropical cyclone. This particular tropical cyclone is called Gloria, and they give them names that we'll see how that naming system works later on. Right, now what does this trough mean? And then another feature of the winter synoptic chart is the high pressure blocking South Atlantic high pressure, blocking all these mid-latitude cyclones so that they don't affect us in winter or affect us far less often. Associated with this trough, if we follow the wind stream, it goes around us in an anti-clockwise direction and around like that. So to the east of the trough, the wind is from the north and northeast. To the west of the trough, it's from the southeast. Now this relationship of that northeast wind here and the southeast wind over the Cape is very typical of summer. The southeast wind over the Cape is a hot, dry wind, and the northeast wind is a warm, moist wind. And that results in rain east of the trough axis. Then the other feature that we have here is the tropical cyclone. And that is very typical of late summer from December onwards. Very occasionally we have them in December, but usually late January, February, March. As you can see, the synoptic chart is March. Right, so that's some of the Fijiana summer synoptic chart. To have a look at the very next day again, the previous one was the 4th of March. Here we are on the 5th of March. Our tropical cyclone has moved a bit. Our trough is still there. And our mid-latitude cyclones are still being blocked by the high pressures here. So what does this weather forecast do? There is our tropical cyclone. It's now ex-Gloria. In other words, it's weakened. Isobars are further apart. And they're just mentioning that that is what that storm was. It'll probably still cause a bit of rain, but it's not really going to affect our South African weather. What's really affecting our South African weather is the fact that east of the trough axis, the wind is converging. So this tropical, warm, moist air is converging around to the east of this low pressure. Now, convergence causes air to rise. As that wind goes around that low pressure, it then spreads out, it is going to diverge. And again, this is a very, very important summer feature and explains why the west coast of South Africa is dry and the eastern half is much wetter. So that convergence causes thunderstorms and the divergence causes hot weather. And that, again, very typical of a summer situation. And again, I don't expect you to understand it, I'm just illustrating how we use synoptic charts by way of introduction. So there's a huge amount of information on the synoptic charts, and the more you practice, the better you will be.